teaching and learning is a foremost, is of foremost importance. Amen?
Amen?
And in this season that we are in now, the season of Easter, it is critical that we understand who we are and what we must be about.
Yes.
You see, Jesus wasn't simply telling the disciples that they were blessed. Jesus was teaching the disciples that because they are blessed, they have an absolute responsibility to go out and teach others just as Jesus was teaching them. Jesus didn't just want his disciples to hear that they were blessed. Oh, you're so blessed. And somebody comes to you in the morning, how you doing? Oh, I'm blessed. I'm blessed. Rather, Jesus wanted them to know, and not only know, but he wanted them to believe and to experience God's favor that was already upon them. You see, some people don't believe that they are really blessed and highly favored of the Lord. Sometimes we just say it. It just comes out because that's the but we really don't believe it, or we look at things that we can see with these eyes and say, well, I'm not blessed. I don't even have transportation. I'm not blessed. I don't have money to pay all my bills. I'm not blessed because of this or that. Remember that sermon title, Know Who You Are. So why is teaching so important for Jesus? Or for that matter, why is learning so critical for a life of faith? One commentary put it like this in my studies. It's important to remember that who Jesus is simultaneously reveals who we are. For Matthew, the disciples are students and learners. But that learning cannot happen outside of the realm of God's promise. You are blessed. You are the light of the world. You are the salt of the earth. Only with these claims of identity in place can the disciples, can we, live out what Jesus will ask us to do. You see, the Beatitudes are identifiers of discipleship. Now, somebody ought to remember that because part of our church theme this year involves intensified discipleship. Anybody remember that? Huh? We are seeking God first, God's kingdom first, through intensified stewardship, intensified, I'm taking y'all back to planning meeting now, come on, all right, fellowship, intensified worship, intensified discipleship. That means we got to take it up a notch, okay? We can't no longer continue to So without this message of truth that Jesus preached, the Great Commission may never have come to fruition. Amen? Think about it. You are blessed. Know that up front. Take it personal. And understand this, that being blessed is not just for the sake of joy and happiness. But more importantly, being blessed is for the sake of making it through that which will be difficult. This Christian walk, this Christian journey is not always going to be a bed of roses.
Amen.
So the bottom line is that in these troubling